Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. Where does gravity fit in the Electric Universe? Contrary to a somewhat common misperception, the Electric Universe does not deny gravity's existence, nor its role in the cosmos and our own world. Rather, the Electric Universe theory, as proposed by physicist Wal Thornhill, suggests that the fundamental mysteries of gravity may be explained by the electrical structure of matter. In his 2008 article, Electric Gravity in an Electric Universe, Thornhill asks, when we apply force to a body, how is that force transferred to overcome inertia? The answer is, electrically, by the repulsion between the outer electrons and the atoms closest to the points of contact. The equivalence of inertial and gravitational mass strongly suggests that the force of gravity is a manifestation of the electric force. Today, Bishop Nicholas Sykes further elaborates the query he first posed in his previous episode, "What is the speed of gravity?" And he elaborates the explanations for gravity that the Electric Universe proposes.
My last Space News video about the light-exceeding speed of gravity, titled "What is the speed of gravity?" provoked some reactions. Someone wondered if I had never heard that gravity was not a force but a bending of the fabric of space-time. Another argued that gravity did not need explanation because it was something that was just there. Einstein's proposition that nothing can travel faster than light has become so entrenched that even some of us identifying with the EU model as a whole find it difficult to give fair consideration to the claim that gravity operating as a real force requiring a real explanation necessitates a real transmission far greater than the speed of light. Yet even if we are only at the beginning of providing such an explanation, it is important for the integrity of the EU model to adhere always to a simple force-based model for gravity, because gravity does, when all is said and done, manifest itself to our senses as a force. The Electric Universe model is constructed with explanations that invariably exclude just their formulations, which are, in effect, widely used agreements to discard the need for rational explanation. As a result of such agreements, the scientific landscape is littered with such follies as black holes, dark matter, dark energy, multiverses, and magnetic reconnection, all of them being just their formulations without rational explanation designed to plug the holes in popular science theory with the unexplainable. Sir Isaac Newton understood that he was unable to formulate an explanation for gravitational attractions, even while he described the behavior mathematically of bodies under gravitational influence over vast distances with astounding accuracy. He speculated on gravity's cause, but decided to leave that issue to a future generation who might bring better tools than his to master the task. Our own generation does indeed have better tools than his, but we have become distracted from the task he and others bequeathed to us by a multitude of follies. These consist of the extraordinary plethora of the just-there formulations that prevent us from accomplishing what Newton and others bequeathed to a future age. If one reads the book Relativity by Albert Einstein, published, for example, in 2004 by the Folio Society, one will see that he develops the concept of light or electromagnetic radiation being the fastest possible messenger merely by assuming that since nothing was observed to go faster than light, then there is no credibility to the idea that anything could go any faster than light. In chapters 7, 8, and 9, for instance, he assumes that information from two simultaneous flashes of lightning could never, by principle, reach an observer any faster than light speed in a vacuum. From that simple idea, the whole theory of relativity was developed, starting with the deduction that two simultaneous events in one frame of reference might not be simultaneous in a different frame of reference. The theory of relativity, as conceived by Einstein, depended therefore entirely on the idea that one could never make deductions about space and time that might ultimately rest upon anything going faster than the speed of light. It is therefore illogical to assert, without any other reason for doing so than the theory of relativity itself, that nothing can go faster than the speed of light. To make such an assertion would be to engage in a tautology, i.e. circular reasoning, because the theory of relativity is founded upon that assertion in the first place. Only if the theory were independently and incontrovertibly verified by observation or experiments might this be reasonable. And such is often assumed to be the case, as Einstein himself hoped that it would be. But so far as I am aware, there is not a single case of this theory's verification that may not reasonably be disputed. Under these circumstances, therefore, it is entirely scientific to consider the possibility that there may well be something observable or reasonably deduced travelling at a speed faster than light. As has already been indicated in my videos, the motion of the planets in the solar system requires that the force of gravity between the Sun and its planets, assuming as we must that this is a real force and not a mental construction of some kind, must be transmitted between them at a speed many orders of magnitude faster than the speed of light. And the physicist Wal Thornhill shows also that such speeds of force transmission are just as necessary within what we call the fundamental particles of matter for the stability of those subatomic structures as it is for the stability of stellar planetary systems. Indeed, by such concepts, the physical foundation of the mathematical structures of quantum mechanics may yet be revealed and made clear in a way similar, perhaps, to the clarification of the physical foundation to Sir Isaac Newton's mathematical principles of gravitational action, that great task that he and others bequeathed to generations yet to come. In such manner, the electric universe model holds out a great promise, the promise of a physics and a cosmology that rest upon a secure foundation to replace what is taught in our prestigious schools, the current model, which, as Einstein himself discerned, relies upon two foundations, the theory of relativity and quantum mechanics, that are themselves mutually irreconcilable.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.